we know where we want to be, and this is a stepping stone to get us back, man. I know I gotta take the hard road, man, and this is it, you know what I mean? But we prepared, we ready, and I'm looking forward to Saturday night.
Now, going back to December 1st, how did you have that fight? Deontay Wilder versus Tyson Fury.
Man, it was a good fight, you know what I mean? Back and forth, man. Deontay had the big knockdowns. I had Fury winning a lot of the rounds, and Deontay almost took his head off in the 12th round, man. But you know what I mean? That's what I thought. The fight went exactly how I thought it was gonna go. If Deontay knocked him out, if it didn't, then I thought Tyson Fury was gonna win the decision.
What champion would you want upon beating Pronouncement? You got two options. Or the lineal. You got the lineal as well.
Yeah, man. You know, any of those fights would be great for me. You know what I mean? But like I said, man, I'm just one fight at a time, just working our way back. And it's gonna be an action-packed fight. You know what I'm saying? This fight gonna be it's gonna be a great, exciting fight. I know it. I feel it. You know what I mean? I'm here. I'm back in New York again. I'm excited about it.
Alan Pronowski throws a lot of punches without head movement, so I think it's gonna be kind of rock and sock and robots, possibly.
Yeah. Well,
now unless you have your athleticism from USC days,
yeah,
you know
man.
I mean,
I got it all, man. But we're gonna see everything that I've learned from my last, you know, from my last time here to now, you know what I mean, and see if that makes a difference.
Adam wasn't shy in saying that he wants to do better than Big Baby and Wilder against you in the press conference.
Yeah.
Is there anything in particular you're preparing for with Adam differently?
I just know he's going to come. You know what I'm saying? I know he's going to come, and I know what type of fighter he is. You know what I mean? So it's up to – I mean – We're gonna see, man. You know what I mean? I didn't come here to lose. You know what I'm saying? I came here to win and get back on the right track and get myself back in contention to fight for a heavyweight world title. You know what I'm saying? And I'm bringing everything that I got with me.
You talk about actually Deontay Wilder. Most people had you up for your first four rounds.
Yeah.
Those three rounds, you composite those three rounds. Is that the Gerald Washington that everyone should be familiar with?
Nah, I mean that's just the styles make the fight, right? You see that fight, and yeah, I was doing very well in that fight. You know, just kind of like similar to Tyson Fury was doing. You know, I mean he wasn't doing the most, but he was winning the rounds. You know what I'm saying? That's where I was going with that. I knew that I was stylistically, that's the type of fighter that I was going to go. If I clipped him, then I was going to do my thing. This is a different type of fight. You know what I mean? This guy is coming. This is not a boxing in a standoff boxing match. You know what I'm saying? This is where y'all gonna have to see my skills. You know what I'm saying? Come to light. If I don't got it, then it ain't gonna. You know what I mean? Then it's gonna be his night. So I gotta bring everything that I got. You know what I'm saying? To deal with that.
How'd your inside work? We're gonna see, man.
Does Adam bring anything different, in your opinion, than you know a guy like Big Baby, who's also very big, throws a lot of punches?
I think he's more active. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he could get a high punch count, but I mean, so does Big Baby if you let him. You know what I mean? It's all about what you allow the other guy to do. If you got to impose your will on them, you can't let them impose their will on you. You know what I'm saying? You watch a guy like, you know, Bernard Hopkins, you know what I'm saying? And you watch him against, you know, Kelly Pavlik or Trinidad or any of those guys, man, he dismantled those guys, you know what I'm saying? And it ain't like those guys know how to fight, man. It's just like crazy to see, man, somebody with some skill, you know what I mean, that really, you take those guys to school, man, and just shut down their whole offense and then work on them when they want to and kind of just, it's like, damn, he ain't working that hard. Really, he is, you know what I'm saying? It's a skill set that you got to learn, man. So I'm going to say skills pay the bills.
Is B-Hop someone you've been looking at, maybe studying?
B-Hop is always, man, he's always a fighter that I like to, you know, that I like to watch. You know what I mean? I like to watch the smarter fighters. I'm late to this game. I started when I was 30 years old. I got, a handful of amateur fights, and then I turned pro. You know what I mean? Next thing you know, I'm fighting for a world title. I was like, damn, you know what I'm saying? So my experience, everything that I've done has been learned on the job. You know what I'm saying? So I'm excited to have. I got a great training squad with me. I got Shadid Saluki, and he's had a Landon Brewster. You know what I mean? When he beat Vladimir Klitschko. So he got somebody on. He's been there before. You know what I'm saying? He's been to the mountaintop before, and he got the experience, man. And he's sharing that with me. So I'm very excited.
What's your take on Anthony Joshua? Do you think he's afraid to come over to America, afraid to fight the heavyweights of America like Deontay Wilder, or he just want to stay in his lane over the UK?
I mean, he definitely got a beautiful lane over there, right? He doesn't really have to. You know what I mean? Everybody is willing to go over there. You know what I mean? He's a champion. He has all the belts. You know what I mean? I don't see why he would have to leave. That's his home. If he wants to fight over there and defend it over there, come get it from here. Come get it from my house. You know what I'm saying? And then once you have it, then you can take it back to your house. But until then, you got to go over there, right? That's how I see it.
Dillian White, I was at the fighting event last week. Dillian White has interest in the PGC. Dillian White being a fight, you be interested in?
Man, all those fights are over there, man. Those are great fights, you know what I'm saying? I'm excited that we have so many heavyweights, you know what I'm saying, in the mix over there. They doing their thing over here. We doing our thing over here. You know what I'm saying? And it's bound to come together, you know what I mean? And when it comes together, it's going to be a beautiful thing for all the fighters, man, for our careers. It's going to help everybody out, man, and it's going to get boxing, take it back to where it used to be.
Two more questions.
Most urgent I've ever heard you, man. You usually laid back Gerald, man. This is the most urgent.
I'm good, man.
You find it weird that he would come over here and fight Bender, but you would do it with Wilder?
I mean, see, Wilder, it depends what type of fight you bring to Wilder, you know what I mean? That's what makes Wilder vicious. Like, if you come into him, yeah, he could sit back and crack, you know, find a shot how to get it in and crack, you know what I'm saying? That's more of an Anthony Joshua type style. Then I knew Tyson Fury was gonna give him a little problem, you know what I mean? Because the way that I fought him, I was like, okay, I could do a Tyson Fury gonna be able to do that same similar style and be able to do his thing, gonna be able to just kind of like, he ain't gonna beat up Wilder, but he gonna be able to play the game with him, you know what I mean? And that's what. But,
any messages for the first friends?